Robinson to take it out. Sims comes for it. Defended by DeShields. Makes the spin move. Pump fake. Sims hits. Gives Minnesota the advantage. She's become the Lynx leader. Boom. Cold look.
Oof. No prom night nerves there from Sims. Are you kidding me? Floater to go. Spin to win, Lisa, and how about the head fake to boot?
And Vandersloot looks like he even got a piece of that shot.
Fouls as a defender. Now here's Charles with Dantas on her. Right behind the line. Drive, swatted away. What a block by Sylvia Fouls.
Yeah, this is a big defensive play right here by Sylvia Fouls, who has been outstanding in the second half of this game, but yep. She does not.
Incredible.
Just an incredibly athletic play. In fact, Ben Lane gets the putback to fall.
Time frame, it seems, if it was on Nurse.
And let's take a look at the contact. They did call it on Nurse. The ball was put back up while there was still plenty of time on the game clock.
Yeah.
And that's not a lot of contact.
Not right. That does this all the time.
3 seconds left. Brown gets it off. Gets it in! How about that for a third quarter finish? Possessions in that third quarter. Officials will take a look at it, but it looks good.
Sims with two to shoot. Brown has to force it up and banks it in. Now let's see whether or not she traveled before. I think she kept that right foot down.
I think you're right.
It looked like she did because it was sort of unorthodox, but
it's where she really benefited from being a lefty.
Here's De'Erica Hamby in for Kelsey Plum as the first sub of the game. Up ahead to Dantas. She catches the pass from Robinson.
Lexi Brown hits the three.
Liberty, Fever, Dallas, and Atlanta. So it looks like the eight teams are pretty much set. A nice block out of bounds by Jillian Aileen.
Potentially could be. She has shown spurts of that, especially here this year. Her first falls, and the career night continues for Asia Taylor.
Two other players in double figures, Natasha with 10 and Alicia Clark with 10. Here's Collier forcing her way in against the veteran Clark, and the rookie will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, out of Connecticut, and her mid-range game is her strength. And
I'm looking past this one right now because it's a good one, but I'm already got that one circled on my calendar.
Robinson reverses it around Williams. Nifty finish by the veteran Danielle Robinson.
Minnesota is hoping to clinch a playoff berth tonight. Wow, D-Rob with the contact and the finish and one. Continuing with the aggression we've seen all night. That's as nice a hoop.
Wilson will take a couple dribbles, find Young, who is rudely blocked by Sylvia Fouls to a rookie. But that's what she's expected to do. Baseline inbound coming up.
First half of basketball in the first game of the season for either team. Brown. There it is. Minnesota's first three of the night.
Nice smile from Brown.
Collier, taller guard.
Through the middle. What a beautiful pass. Threading that needle.
Reading where Liz Cambage is already in the help. Great look. De'Erica Hamby there, but Big Sill going on the other side and finishing.
First by Coffey, the second by Williams. Montgomery's stop and pop is around and out. Over the top, in transition to Fouls. How about that delivery from the backcourt to make it a two-point game?
Odyssey Sims to work against the defense. Nice pass to Sylvia Fouls, who finishes. And that's a key for Minnesota.
It really is.
See Brown on the floor. You got to go over the top of all that screening action. Everyone else, Fever, are going under. Lexi Brown's our best three-point shooter. That's a terrific move.
There was again another reaction. You and I just pointed to it. Stolen away by Robinson. Look out behind. Brown with the finish.
Lexi representing the bench for Minnesota tonight. Robinson has done so much, but her ability to turn you over and then push the pace on the other end.
Sims pushing, her pass tapped away, stolen, and it is a three-on-one. Powers is blocked by Dantas, a three-on-one.
Ruiz gets denied by Collier. How good has the defense been of this rookie? Nafisa Collier finds Brown. She got it! Minnesota back in front.
So many times this Minnesota team this season has had to rely on their defense, and Nafisa Collier getting the block, pushing the ball the other way, making the extra pass. Lexi Brown drain.
Enigwe with the defense. Lexi Brown with a couple of threes off the bench.
Look at Vegas with the defense too. He's not giving the Lynx an inch to breathe. Brown catches Las Vegas in rotation.
Yeah, she's back. Yes. Simone Augustus is officially back. Breaks the 8-0 dream run. Coffee tanks it to the rim, but got rejected by Fouls.
Here in this third quarter where Minnesota has surged back after being down 12.
Inside a minute to play. Two-point game. Brown's got to force one up at the shot clock buzzer. My goodness, the first lead of the game.
Much more rhythm to the second half here.
Fouls inside to Danielle Robinson. Bucket and the foul. Boy caught sleeping.
Certainly a low-scoring affair for both squads, especially the Liberty. Just haven't been able to get a flow.
See if both teams can defend without fouling. If we can get some flow to this game for a little bit. Wow. As Odyssey Sims comes down the triple.
What he thinks of the officials. Here's Nafisa Collier. Now Robinson, 10 to shoot. High arcing three on the way. Bingo. Danielle Robinson knocks down the three. That's her first of the season.
Well, you know this Indiana team isn't giving up. We've watched them come back from down 20. So twice. Fouls again. She's made five consecutive shots. Where they play with a lot of pace. They'll get up and down the court. You have to be ready. Fouls puts it one way and then the other and then in. Sylvia Fouls is 4 of 4 with 8 points.
It'll be a Fouls three-team deal. Made her a restricted free agent offer. And Atlanta could not match. Talbot with a steal. And a driving layup. No. Tip followed the buzzer. Good for Danielle Robinson.